Hello and welcome to this video about fixing your forward head posture and rounded shoulders, also known as upper cross syndrome, as described by Kang et al. In the year 2018. According to a study by Cook et al. In the year 2005, intolerance to prolonged static postures, fatigue, an inability to hold the head up, better sitting with external support from the hands, and frequent cracking of the neck were symptoms indicating possible instability and weakening of the neck and shoulder muscles. If you recognize yourself in these indicators, then this video is a must-see. So how does this problem arise? Rounded shoulders and increased extension of the upper neck causes degeneration of the neck muscles and causes changes in this region. Specifically, the deep neck flexor muscles and the scapular retractors, such as the lower trapezius and the serratus anterior muscle. Then, all these factors combined cause a malalignment of the neck, a tilting in posture, and an imbalance of the muscles, which in time can lead to pain. So, what is the solution? According to studies by Kang and Yeo et al., neck problems can be best treated by not only incorporating neck exercises, but also targeting the scapular region. So without any further ado, let's get started with the first exercise. The first exercise in this video targets the thoracic spine mobility, which according to a study by Cleland et al. In the year 2004, should be targeted first before starting the strengthening exercises. As described in a study by Yeo in the year 2013, the first exercise is done in a supine position with a foam roller placed at the middle of the thoracic spine. Then, while keeping the foam roller in place, you round your lower back so the most extension takes place in the thoracic spine when extending your upper back over the foam roller. Keep in mind that your neck stays in a neutral position and doesn't overextend during the performance of this exercise. A second thoracic spine mobility exercise can be done by using a chair. To perform this exercise, put both hands in your neck and point your elbows forward. Then round your lower back so that the most extension takes place in the thoracic spine when extending your upper back over the tip of the chair. According to the study by Yeo, these exercises should be performed 30 times. Next up is the reversed wall slide exercise in a standing position, also known as the candle exercise. This exercise was described by Candle et al. In the year 1993, Salmon in the year 2001, and by Park and Lee in the year 2020. The reversed wall sliding exercise is a lower trapezius strengthening exercise in a standing position where both arms are lifted above the head. To perform this exercise, stand with your back against the wall, heels about 3 inches or 10 centimeters from the wall with knees slightly bent. Then, posturally tilt your pelvis against the wall, flattening the lower back to further increase the effectiveness of this exercise. Then, place your hands beside your head with your elbows and hands touching the wall by abducting the shoulder, externally rotating to 90 degrees and flexing your elbows to 90 degrees. An optional chin tuck can be performed to make this exercise more advanced. From this position, lift both arms up and down by contracting the lower trapezius without the compensation of the upper trapezius. While performing this exercise, breathe in with your hands towards the ceiling and breathe out when going back to a 90 degree elbow position. Repeat this exercise for 3 sets of 10 repetitions. Another exercise for targeting the lower trapezius is the modified prone cobra exercise. This exercise was described by Arlotta et al. In the year 2011 and by Park and Lee in the year 2020. To perform this exercise, lay in a prone position with your arms by your side and fingers pointing towards your toes. Then move into a trunk extension, raising your chest approximately 10 centimeters or 4 inches off the undersurface. From this position, with your palms turned out and thumbs pointing up towards the ceiling, pull your shoulder blades back and push them down as if your fingertips are reaching your feet. While doing this exercise, make sure you keep this final position for 10 seconds and repeat this exercise 10 times. The modified prone cobra exercise elicits the least amount of concurrent upper trapezius activity, thus encouraging better isolation of the lower trapezius muscle, and is considered the best exercise for selective strengthening of the lower trapezius muscle according to the study by Arlotta et al. In the year 2011. Next up is the serratus wall slide, which is an effective exercise to activate the serratus anterior muscle above 90 degrees of shoulder elevation, because the serratus anterior is a key muscle in stabilizing the shoulder blades. This exercise was described by Hardwick et al. In the year 2006 and generated an MVIC of 37.1% at 90 degrees, 58.3% at 120 degrees, and 75.7% at 140 degrees. To perform this exercise, stand in an upright position facing a smooth wall with the dominant foot against the base of the wall and with the opposite foot shoulder-wide apart and behind the dominant foot. Then place your forearms in contact with the wall and the shoulders and elbows at a 90 degree angle. The shoulders should be placed in a plane approximating the scapular plane. Then slide the forearms up the wall while leaning into it by transferring body weight from the non-dominant foot to the dominant foot. This staggered foot position helps to shift your weight forward as you slide up the wall. While doing this exercise, try bringing your shoulder blades out and around as you slide up the wall. At the end of the movement, maximal shoulder elevation should be obtained. Variations may be applied to activate the serratus anterior muscle more, such as a resistance band, a foam roller, or a combination of both. The last and final exercise in this video is the chin tuck exercise, which targets the weak and deep neck flexor muscles, according to a study by Kim et al. In the year 2016. To target this muscle group, the chin tuck exercise can be performed and progressed in a prone, supine, and seated position. To perform the chin tuck exercise, tuck in your chin for 10 seconds at an intensity that doesn't cause cramping or pain in the neck area. After 10 seconds, release the tension, take a 10 second rest, and repeat this exercise for 10 times 10 seconds. This exercise can be done multiple times during the day. Another variation is the chin tuck in a seated position. To perform this exercise, tuck in your chin in a horizontal line while holding it for 10 seconds. The chin tuck variation in prone position has been implemented in the modified prone cobra exercise and is a less intense variation of the chin tuck in a supine and seated position. I hope you enjoyed this video about the best exercises for fixing your forward head posture. For more information about the best science-based lower trapezius and serratus anterior muscle exercises, click on these videos next to me. And also, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. For now, see you in my next video.